Hundreds gathered in Karich, Bayam, in Rumbek East earlier this week for the groundbreaking ceremony of the construction of the two roads from Karich to Amok Piny and Aluakluak to Akuoc Cok. After jumping over a white bull slaughtered in his honor, Governor Chol Tong Mayai cut a ceremonial yellow ribbon tied on two poles to officially begin construction on the road connecting Karich to Amok Piny Payam. The governor told those in attendance that such projects are a realization of the late SPLM leader John Garang's vision of taking towns to the people.
This is the fertile land, agricultural land. This is going to be a productive land. So we are connecting the producers with the market, because this road is the main road which will take all thy goods to market. This population also have been a little bit isolated from the rest of the state. It is also within the vision of our late leader that we have to take towns to the people. By taking this road, this migration to town will stop, because you get most population of that area now, they are staying here because they are lacking facilities like medical facilities, education. With this road going there, teachers will be going, medical facilities will be going, security is going to be there. So it is really a very vital feeder road for us.
This planned road connecting Karich to Amok Piny Payam will be 65 kilometers long and is expected to take 11 months to complete. Like many other infrastructure projects in South Sudan, most roads here were left in shambles during the long civil war between the then North Sudan and the now independent South Sudan. Many of South Sudan's roads are still in poor condition, although the government and NGOs are working on maintaining key routes and emergency roads in the region. Locals here say the road was last repaired in the 1980s, but the condition is so bad that the new road will be built from scratch. WFP Lake State Director Wilfred Tokpa says the construction of new roads will help boost trade and productivity among agricultural communities.
We have chosen a road looking at the importance that if the roads are open, that will help to enhance the movement of people accessing market, you know, and then that will also assist the community at large, and also our program, where you're going to have a lot of schools opening up, and there will be a lot of other activities to follow. But thereafter, as I said, this is just the beginning of this project.
But some in the local community believe the roads will provide more than economic opportunities. South Sudan has the highest mortality rate in Africa, according to the United Nations Population Fund. The chief of Karich, Manyang Blingatem, believes that access to the road will help pregnant women and other sick people.
Kebu konya ran twan ku katar ka jan turbil bi rian kwer kwer ene ya pen kwer ne ya bai cha banan mo jang le yin be bal jam le yib rur in le yib ku kwer kon puri o kwer pur la fan jan bi tiam ku bi ga ket pandu yi pol go ke yen men nen kwer no ko koy anan ko le yib to ga kan ka yu no bu konya rit actor men ke koy.
I think the community is so optimistic about the road that will bring a positive impact on them. For instance, Lake Ibor, it has a lot of potential of fish that people expect that when this road is completed, they will get that fish from there and it will benefit and it will supplement on their diet. That's one. Then also, they will get milk from there, because during dry season, most of the cattle came do stay around the lake, and then people will get milk from there. Then also, on the other side, when there is any problem in the lake, it will be very good when the road is done. People like organized forces will move from here very easily and quickly and rescue the situation.
The road construction is also providing immediate economic opportunity to nearby communities. For many residents of Karich, many of whom survive on less than $1 per day, the road provides a source of important income.
and karba. And then in the king and thor be by shoot and we be a shoot and malok akal ne china jal yebukwer ne ko rane cholo kuma asal pa ke le rit ke ke cholta
$10 million has been budgeted for the construction of the two feeder roads, which will cover a total of 114 kilometers. They are funded by the South Sudan Recovery Fund and are being constructed as part of the Lake State Stabilization Program under the management of the World Food Program. As you can see, this road starts from nowhere and almost ends nowhere. During the long civil war between the North Sudan and the now independent South Sudan, almost all infrastructures in South Sudan were left in shambles, including the roads. But there is hope that linking these feeder roads would bring basic services to the people living along this road, services like schools, services like hospitals, and even education. For Sudan Votes, I am Mavis Bilunji in Aluakluak, Yerol West of Lake State in South Sudan.